Hi everyone! As you may know, how to make single-sided PCBs at home is common knowledge, with plenty of tutorials on the internet. But making double-sided PCBs is a different story. The main challenge in double-sided PCBs is of course vias, which are holes that need to be plated with copper to electrically connect the top and bottom side of the PCB. Although this is done routinely in the industry, as far as I know at least, there is simply no documented step-by-step tutorial targeted to the home experimenter. Making single-sided PCBs is what first got me into chemistry, and I have been experimenting with a way to make double-sided PCBs since at least 2017. But first, a disclaimer. The experiment that I am going to describe today is still a failure, and I don't know when or even if I will be able to succeed in my goal. As this was just meant to be another of the many experiments I've done, I didn't film it. So all I can show you for now is just pictures of the various steps. The process I'm experimenting with begins with a raw board with copper on both sides, but no photoresist. The board is drilled with my CNC to make the holes for the vias. It is then sandpapered to remove burrs left by the drilling process. Then it is cleaned in dilute sulfuric acid, and the surface is activated with a palladium chloride solution. After that, it is immersed in an electroless copper plating solution, which uses formaldehyde to reduce copper ions, depositing a thin layer of copper on the entire board, including the whole walls. This copper layer is too thin to be useful directly, but it is instead used as a conductive base onto which more copper is deposited electrolytically. So the next bath is an electrolytic copper bath. At this point, the board is uniformly coated in copper, and as you can see, all the whole walls are coated in copper as well. The hardest part, however, is what comes next, as we need to etch the copper where we don't need it to make the various circuit traces, and we need to do this without destroying the copper inside the holes. For this, we coat the PCB with a photoresist material, expose it through a mask with ultraviolet light, and develop it. If you look closely, the photoresist patterns are a negative image, that is, the photoresist is present where we do not want copper. I tried before using a positive image and just dipping the PCB in a copper etchant, but this approach didn't work, as it's hard to protect the copper inside the holes from the etchant. So, the approach I'm trying is called thin pattern plating, where the copper that we want to keep is coated in a protective layer of thin metal, deposited electrolytically. After this is done, the photoresist is stripped, exposing the copper that we want to etch away. Here, however, the problems begin. We need to use an etchant that selectively attacks copper and not tin, such as persulfate. But while a normal PCB is fully etched within half an hour or so, PCBs where I have deposited copper seem to take forever to etch. Here is what it looks like after 2 hours. As you can see, there is some stubborn copper that refuses to etch. After 4 hours, I stopped the etching, as some tracks began to dissolve as well. And this is the final result. A detail under the microscope shows that some tracks dissolved and some shorts remain, but also that some copper remained in the holes after the etching. I performed a test with a multimeter, and 48% of holes have electrical continuity. This is the first time I get more than 0% of holes with electrical continuity, so while it's still a failure, at least I'm making progress.